raining pretty hard out there.
Say, you packed my lunch, Phil?
I just don't get how we haven't cracked this case yet.
Well, some people would say we have high levels of incompetence.
And that's bogus. We're the best daggum PIs this town has ever seen.
Whoa. I don't have a PI. I get tested weekly.
Private investigators, Fed. Keep up, please.
I mean, we've searched everywhere on the map. Guy covers his tracks well.
Not well enough.
Well, what do you know? What now?
We do what detectives do.
Wear our coats over our shoulders?
Precisely. Code number one of being a detective is you have to wear your coat over your shoulder. So?
Detective code number two. Never miss a snack before and after a meal.
And code number three. Do cool detective stuff. Let's roll.
The cops have already come to this crime scene, but my buddy and I have an eye for this sort of thing. We knew they had to have missed something.
Now keep your eyes peeled for any clues that might lead us to where the killer is. Yes, like this paper heart. They've been at every single crime scene that we've been to. Hey, I'll get it. Yes, the paper heart. Must mean that he'll be at the paper factory.
You're onto something.
Let's go.
Since we found a paper heart at the crime scene, the only logical conclusion was that the killer had to be at the paper factory.
Well, do you think breaking and entering is still illegal?
Not for us. We're above the law. Who's that suspicious individual over there?
Well, it doesn't really matter now, does it? We're not looking for a suspicious individual. We're looking for a suspicious person.
You're right. That's my bad, my bad.
It's okay. Well, you want to go see what's playing in the theater now?
With a killer on the loose?
Well, be honest. We didn't find him in the paper factory. Do you really think that we're going to find him at all?
You know what happened to the last honest guy that went in the movie theater?
No.
Let's go. That was the cold-hearted killer, all right, and he's dead.
So he was at the paper factory?
No, that was on the arrow, which I went back to get. That's why it took me so long. No other reason.
Well, so what now? He's dead? All of our hard work for nothing? We finally cracked the case, Phed. With our pure wit and will, and we weren't even the ones to retire him. I just don't know how I should feel right now.
Probably pretty happy, considering all the men and women and children he's murdered.
I guess so, but that leaves us with nothing to do now. Peanut butter with no jelly.
Where?
Oh, well, what about the killer? The killer's killer.
Well, he got away from me. He was too fast, but barely.
I would have caught him. But I guess that's just another case for us to catch.
You're right. Let's go catch this case.
Say, Phil, why's the arrow all wet and sticky?
Well, that's probably the blood, Fed.
No, past the blood. Look, there's some weird red weird stuff on the arrow.
Yeah. Well, we'll send this down to Dr. Carter at the crime lab and see if he can figure out what this is. Dr. Carter down at the lab. It's gonna take a little time, but he said he's gonna figure out what that residue on the arrow was. Until then, how's deciphering the code going?
It'd probably help if I could read.
Well, probably. Let me see this. A place where you want to walk, but not on the top. A place down below is where you want to go. I'll be waiting for you two. My arrows won't be dry, but by the end of this, you will both surely die. What could this mean?
You know? I think it means he's trying to kill us.
Possibly, but I'm not going to be too sure of anything just yet.
While we waited for the lab results on the arrow we found lodged inside the cold-hearted killer's cold-hearted stomach, we found a man who might have some answers, so we brought him in for some questioning. Tony Paroni, Italian restaurant owner that lets us get a free meal weekly as long as we don't go into the back room, because he says things tend to get a little messy in there. Criminal record-wise, he's been bailed out of jail on multiple accounts and hasn't been sent to court in the last week and a half. Tell us what you know, Paroni.
Look, you got the wrong guy. Trust me, I ain't the guy that you're looking for. You think I would ice the cold-hearted killer? No, it's bad for business.
So you guys were acquaintances then?
I didn't say that.
How often did you meet with him, Paroni?
I don't meet with nobody. They meet with me. Tony Paroni.
Well, let's say he met with you often. Do you know anyone that would have a grudge against him?
Yeah, your mother.
Look, we're not getting anywhere with Mr. Eiffel Tower over here. I say we just do good cop, bad cop.
Mind if I say something?
Take it away.
Tony Paroni's pizza sauce. $5.99, all organic. Wouldn't it be a shame if somebody smashed it all over that expensive stolen shirt you got on?
You know why you wouldn't dare, okay? My grandmother Mia, she cooked that. It's perfection. It's the best pizza sauce in the business. Delicious, right?
It's pretty tasty.
Exactly. You know what? That wouldn't be a waste of my shirt. That would be a waste of the pizza sauce.
Tony Pepperoni.
Who told you about Tony Pepperoni, huh? Who? The kid who stole lunch money from me in third grade? What about him? I mean, he's dead now, but, you know, I didn't have anything to do with it, you know. I promise. But here's the thing. I recommend you don't mention his name so lightly anymore. Thought you're supposed to be the good cop, eh?
I'm sorry, Tony. I didn't realize that it hurt you so much.
Ah, I'm just pulling your leg. He is dead, though.
Phil, you mind if I say something?
Go ahead.
Listen here, you big sack of meatballs! I want you to use your noodle!
Get it? Because you're Italian?
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Thank you.
I want you to use your noodle to tell me everything you know about the killer!
You might want to talk outside. I'm about to give him some of the special Phed sauce, if you know what I mean.
My deepest apologies for arriving to the scene so late. There was a fire, it nicked me real good, and I lost all the evidence, okay?
Okay.
Okay. So that red sticky stuff, as you refer to it, is only available in the black market, okay? It's a special compound, and I have absolutely no idea where your perp got it from, okay?
Okay, so what does this red sticky stuff actually do?
It is a poison called Cupid's Kiss.
Well, Cupid does have a ring to it.
Indeed it does. And according to my calculations, it renders all victims unconscious until true love wakes them up. Whoever made this must be a real a heart of broken.
Hey, who do you think you are talking to me like that?
I am Phed!
You don't even know where he gets it from, what he looks like besides a heart tattoo on his face, or what this stupid note even means.
A note?
Yeah, this note he left. Here you go.
It's the Lockman Bridge.
How did you figure that out so fast?
The place where you walk, but not on the top, the place down below is where you want to go. A bridge. You don't want to walk on top of the bridge. You know, the Walkman Bridge. You don't walk on top of it. You always walk below it. That's what most people do. I'll be waiting for you too. My arrows won't be dry. They're going to be wet because of the water. And by the end of this, you'll voluntarily die. That really doesn't have much to do with the bridge, but you get my point.
Yeah, I didn't think it'd be something so obvious.
Well, I thought you were detectives.
And you see, that's what I told him. Nobody. I mean nobody. Messes with my meatballs.
Well, we'll be down there all the time for those meatballs.
Hey, for you, buddy, it's open every time.
Meatballs.
What happened?
Yeah, he's a pretty good guy, actually. He's just misunderstood. Yeah, but he said if we ever need any help, just tell him and he'll send his boys.
Good to know.
Yeah, so what about the arrow?
Black market poison called Cupid's Kiss. Renders the victim completely unconscious, can only be awoken by true love. Right, Doc?
Yes, indeed.
I see.
And about the note, it's been confirmed that he will be at the Walkman's Bridge, like I said earlier.
Right, like you said earlier.
Wink, wink. You ready to go?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Hey, you know, I'm not seeing anything out here.
I could have sworn I was right.
I thought you were a doctor.
Over there.
Get down on the ground, Cupid! Get down!
We got you, you diaper-wearing angel baby.
Wrong Cupid, buddy. But this was surprisingly easy.
The cold-hearted killer!
We saw you die.
Death, like love, is an illusion, my friends.
What are you doing with Cupid's hat?
And what are you doing with that vial that looks suspiciously like Cupid's kiss?
You're supposed to be detectives. Right.
Carter, you're Cupid?
Oh my gosh, it all makes sense. If you rearrange the letters in Carter, you get Cupid.
How did I not catch that?
What? No, it doesn't.
You're a doctor, not an English teacher.
But why the killings?
Yeah, why'd you do it?
It all started on Valentine's Day. My girlfriend broke up with me on what was, ironically, her favorite holiday. Said I wasn't romantic enough. Then, I became Cupid. I put an arrow through her heart, like she did mine. Except, hers was metaphorical, and mine was literal.
So what I'm hearing is you've ruined every chance you had of getting back with her.
That was pretty stupid of you.
Yeah, what do you have a PhD in? Being stupid?
I realized that my chemical can make others feel like I do. Victims would be left lifeless because they had no true love, like me. Then, I heard of Phil and Phed. I hired the cold-hearted killer to keep you two distracted while I completed my work.
But how do you live? You shot him in the theater.
With fake arrow. And the red sticky stuff was a replica of Cupid's kiss, made of blood and glue. And the data is all made up as well. But this is a real Cupid's kiss arrow. So are the rest of my quiver. One touched your skin, and you'll be lifeless until your true love awakens you. But of course, there's no such thing as true love. It's all made up.
But that's not the only thing inside your head. Bet you got dozens of little voices. And stupidity.
Yeah.
Time's up. No love.
Of all the ways that my day could have gone, I was not expecting this.
Remember, Biff, rule number three.
Do the cool detective stuff.
My gun's jammed like jelly!
Well, then I'll cover you like, peanut butter.
Phil!
Phil, I never got my free meatball.
You will, Beth. I'll fix this.
What I didn't tell you is that once the poison reaches your heart, it's over with. You'll be dead.
Think, Phil, think!
Never miss a snack before and after a meal.
That's true love.
Code number one of being a detective is you have to wear your coat over your shoulder.
This is what desperate tender feels like.
Hey, it worked! You're alive!
Never underestimate a man's love of food.
City's ever seen.
Totally!